Hey guys, hope you all are having a good week so far. Mine has been pretty great because I've gotten to see so many of you through Zoom during our unit test. And I wanted to quickly shout you guys out because for the most part, you were really well prepared for the test. And I entered grades already. I think I only have a couple more to enter. It's Tuesday night right now, so I'm gonna finish entering those as soon as I'm done with this. And they will all be up. They will all be entered by the time you're watching this on Wednesday. So go ahead and check your grades and let me know if you have any questions. But like I explained during the test, this can only help you. Like the unit test was, you know, not designed to bring your grade down. So I only entered benchmarks that were beneficial to you. So if, you know, you don't have all five benchmarks entered, that's why. It's because the ones that weren't entered would not have helped your grade. There were a few people who I didn't enter any benchmarks for because none of them would have helped, but I am pretty sure I emailed all of those people. So, yeah, if you have any questions though about it, please just let me know. Definitely on Wednesday today when you're watching this, because grades finalize on Thursday. So there's not really going to be much I can do after that. But yeah, anyways, there was some really awesome performance on that test. Some people who raised their grade significantly, a few people who were not passing the course before taking the test and are now passing. So that's really awesome. And I'm so proud that you guys took the opportunity to strengthen your grade with this test. So we are moving on today from Unit 4 into kind of Unit 5, but really a modified Unit 5. So let me give you some background. Typically, you know, I think I've explained this to you before when we were in school. Our second half of the year is like geometry and then statistics, probability. So geometry, we break into two units. We have the first one we just did, which is really just polygons, you know, any shape that is not a circle. We obviously mostly focused on triangles, but you know, triangles are polygons. And then Unit 5 is circles. So Unit 5 is definitely not as long as Unit 4, but it takes us about a month normally, and it's really nuanced. There's a lot of new information that's honestly pretty challenging. Students tend to find Unit 5 like the hardest from all of the units that we do throughout the year. And to be completely honest, I just didn't feel really comfortable introducing you to a lot of those skills and topics digitally, just because I know this is a challenging time for all of us, and a lot of you are, you know, have expressed that getting help with your classes is not as easy as, you know, it would be if you were in class, and even if you're reaching out, it's just, you know, it's different, and I did not want to overwhelm you with really complicated new material. I did check with Mr. Hone, your math teacher for next year, and he said that for the most part, the circles unit doesn't really relate to what we do or what you're going to do in 11th grade math, but he would be able to cover anything that is relevant for MCAS next year, you know, anything that you would need, he'd be able to kind of fill in the gaps, fill in the blanks, with the exception of writing the equation of a circle. He said that's really critical, and he wanted us to do that this year, and I agree. I think that's like the major takeaway from our circles unit, so that is what we're gonna do. This is also like really a heavy hitter on MCAS and on SAT. The rest of the circle stuff, it's like kind of, but not really, so this is what we're going to focus on. It's only going to take us 2 days. It's really, really short, but very important. And I don't actually think that you're going to have much trouble with it. So that being said, today we are going to graph circles based on their equation. And tomorrow we're going to be given information, either like just written information or a graph, and then we're going to write an equation from it. So the standard form equation of a circle is as follows. I'm going to write it and then explain it. X minus H. Oh my gosh, can you guys hear that? If not, then I probably sound really stupid. But my family is watching some sort of action movie, and this is like the seventh time that I have filmed this video, and I'm really hoping I'm not going to have to do an eighth, because I keep getting interrupted by how ridiculously loud it is. And then also a couple of times I just fumbled my words and said stupid stuff because I'm really tired from grading all day. So hopefully this is the video you're watching and I'm not doing it again. Anyways, this is the standard form for the equation of a circle. So it's x minus h all squared plus y minus k all squared equals r squared. So hk, which is not new to you, you've seen hk before, that is the center of the circle. I hope you remember that when we are graphing quadratic functions, hk is the vertex of the parabola. All right, so center of the circle, vertex of the parabola, it's really just, you know, the important, the focal point of whatever it is that we're doing. And r is the radius. R squared is not the radius, just r. So when we are graphing each circle, what you're going to want to do is identify the center and the radius and go from there. So the center of the circle, HK, keep in mind, just like in your quadratics, where one of the signs flips, the H flips, here the H flips, also the K flips. So in question one, it's X plus 4 squared. The X value of our center is negative 4. That flips. And then the y value, the k, flips as well. So negative 2 is positive 2. So they both flip. It's not like in the quadratics where only h flips. All right? So the center of our circle is negative 4, positive 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 2. Did I do that right? My brain is like not really functioning properly today. Okay, yep, so negative 4, positive 2. And then the radius is r. This is r squared, not r. Meaning you have to take the square root of it, and that's really easy right now because it is a perfect square. The radius is 5. And all we're gonna do to graph that is just count up 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's going to be the top of the circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 down. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 left. And we are going to connect those dots in a circle as best as possible. I actually think I have a fun shape drawing thing here. I'm actually not sure if it works, but we'll try it. I'm like notoriously like really, really bad at drawing circles. Oh my gosh, wow, it works. Kind of. It's not perfect. But much better than what I draw, as you guys saw. So yeah, that is how we graph circles. Let's try a couple more of these together, but then really like that's it. Let's try number two. So for number two, we have x minus 7 squared plus y squared equals 4. So our h value right here is going to be the opposite of what's written there. So that's positive 7. And then our k value, I'm going to give you a second to think, is 0, right? Because y squared is the same as y minus 0 squared. So our center is 7, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oopsies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're not moving vertically at all. 7, 0. And then our radius is the square root of 4 or 2. Up 2, left, down, right 2. And then you're just going to draw that circle, which is obviously not going to look perfect. But do the best that you can. And that's it. All right, let me see what else. Okay. I want you to go ahead and try 3 and 4. You can either pause it, do it now, or do it later. And then we're going to flip to the next page, where we're just going to identify information based on the equation. So we're not actually going to be graphing, just identifying the center and the radius. From the radius, you can do a lot of different things. You can find the diameter because the radius is just half of the diameter, right? You just double the radius to get the diameter. you can get the circumference because the formula for the circumference of a circle involves the radius. Similarly, you can find the area. So we'll just try a couple of those. All right, so when we're looking just for the center and the radius, the center is the HK, right? So this says negative 5, which means that H is actually positive 5. Remember, it's the opposite. So if we're told, you know, anyways, you guys get it. Okay. And then K is the opposite of this, so 1. The center is 5, 1. And the radius is a square root of whatever is here. So the square root of 64 is 8. All right, let's try number 7. So the center is 0, negative 10, right? Because when there's nothing here, it's x minus 0 squared. So the h value is 0, the k value is the opposite of what's here, so negative 10. And then we're asked for diameter, but let's hold off there and let's first find the radius. Obviously, you can't get to the diameter from this, right? You need to go through the radius first. So we need to find the radius, but this isn't a perfect square, but that's okay. So we're just gonna take the square root of it anyways. And the square root of 42.25 is 6.5. It's okay that it's not a perfect square. And from there, to get the diameter, we know that the diameter is 2 times the radius. It's going to be 13. Let's quickly do one where you find the center and then the circumference, and then I promise we'll be finished. So center, again, the opposite of that, so it's negative 2, negative 9. The formula for circumference is 2 pi r. So we need the radius to get to it. So the radius is the square root of 196, which is 14. So it's 2 times pi times 14. And I'm actually going to ask that you guys leave your answer in terms of pi, all right, like this. So 2 times pi times 14 is 28 pi. I want your answer with pi. On standardized tests, you're just going to take your cue from the problem. So if you were doing the same question and it was multiple choice, if all of the answers had pi in them, then you would obviously know to leave it like this. If the answers were irrational and were multiplied by pi, then you would obviously know to multiply by pi. But know that multiplying by pi does not mean multiplying by 3.14. That is not what pi is. Your calculator has a button that says pi. So if you're going to multiply by pi, make sure you're multiplying by that button, which represents the complete series of like places in pi, right? Like the complete irrational number. But for the purpose of this, we're just gonna leave it as 28 pi, and a lot of like MCAS SAT questions will also have you just leave it like pi. But again, take your cue from the question. All right, last one, center, positive 3, negative 4. We're asked for the area. First, we need to find the radius. The radius is the square root of 81, or 9. The formula for the area of a triangle is pi times the radius squared. So we really did not need to take the square root because we would have ended up with the same thing anyways. So in this case, it is 81 pi. And I want you to leave pi, just as we did in the previous question. Okay, so that is it. We're not going to do the general form of a circle because that is not common practice to learn. It's not on standardized tests. This is on standardized tests. And it absolutely will be on MCAS and on SAT, and it's going to be really important to Math 3 next year. So please make sure you are giving it proper attention. Please complete questions 3 and 4, and then all of these right here. All right. And then I'm posting the IXL for you to spend some time on. Tomorrow we will write equations based on given information, which is like really simple. So I think that you will not have any trouble with it, unless you're having trouble with what we're doing today. In that case, please let me know ASAP so that I can help you out. I really want to close this stuff out before April break so we don't have it hanging over our heads, and we're able to come back from break and move on to our final unit of new information for the year. All right. I will talk to you all soon and hope you have a great day.